So infrastructure is not sexy. The British comedian John Oliver proved this. He featured in his well-known show a set of US politicians mentioning that. But yet, his satiric closing was very, very revealing. If anything exciting happens in infrastructure, we have done it wrong. Indeed, infrastructure are like Lego. Building is fun, destroying is also fun, but a Lego maintenance set is the most boring toy ever. Yet, many high-level politicians warn we had to take care of our aging infrastructure. Actually, aging is the most evident problem into infrastructure. But even when they are young and healthy, infrastructures are quite wild beasts. They have grown so complex and intertwined that we even fail to understand how they react to problems. We have already witnessed a tree in Switzerland causing the lights to go back in Sicily. But it's not just because we cannot model, understand, and design infrastructure. The problem is that there is epistemic uncertainty that is so pervasive in these large-scale systems. We lack the capability to know. Humans in the loop oftentimes render our models ineffective. Luckily, resilience has emerged as a changing paradigm to build stronger infrastructure. The US Academy of Sciences defines resilience as the capability to plan, resist, recover, and adapt to adverse events. So, guided by this principle, how do we design resilient infrastructures? Planning is the holy grail of resilience design. We need to be capable to plan over a vast spectrum of hazards looming over them. Resilience tells us to plan for the unpredicted, but how can we do that if we cannot even plan for known weather events? At a longer time scale, we already know we have to plan for a changing climate. At ETH, we study how the energy system can cope with the lack of cooling water. And these issues are not happening somewhere in hot spots of the world. They happen here and now, Switzerland and France. From the science and technology side, we have already tools that can support our design. Infrastructure generates enormous amount of signals, so at ETH we develop predictive maintenance for aging infrastructure, the so-called big data analytics. And when problems strike, well, the planning is over. The real-time action now starts. Well, we need to be capable of detecting tipping points when the system enters unstable states. At ETH, we design tools using sensory system understanding and machine learning that can detect problems. After we detect it, we need to be capable of stopping the cascade of outages from spreading through the system, the domino effect. At ETH, we design cyber-physical systems so that a communication outage does not cascade into the interdependent electricity supply system. Well, no matter how good we are in designing and predicting, any human activity might experience disruption. Well, resilience tells us to adapt and quickly go back to life. We design automatic control and response actions so that we can keep the infrastructure alive even under limited functionality. When we then have physical damage into the system, then we need to activate resources to rebuild, build new, repair. Now the issue becomes also a political issue. It's a trade-off between technical policy making and political decision making. So in the end, how do we build strong infrastructure? Well, we need to be capable of making them hard, making them resistant, making them robust. Well, but this must be done thoughtfully because excessive optimization into the system can actually make it more fragile, more susceptible to new surprises. But also, resilience calls for flexibility. But if we manage the system always to be able to cope with surprises, we might increase the risk that known issues become actually unmanageable. So we need a blend of both resistance and flexibility. So at the end, we need to be capable of building resilience into our community, into people. So what we are doing, our grand issue is to bring all these levels that we have just discussed into the life of people. As one of the early scholars in infrastructure resilience said, resilience is to embrace the change and make people smile again. Thank you very much for your attention.